Hi guys, it's been a while since I've made any video. I'm sorry about that. I was quite busy also with my second child and also with a partner who actually stabbed me in the back. So yeah, as you can see, business can be very, very wild, right? But let's talk about something cool. Let's talk about AeroSwift. I will also show AeroSwift running, for example, in some conferences. So I just wanted for this first demo to show you something that can blow your mind right now. And why actually it will blow in mind, it's because I will be able to just run the bladeRF and YateBTS inside Windows with AeroSwift. And so to begin, we will also download first the binary for AeroSwift Windows. You can also compile it from the project as well. There's like a nice build Windows file, which actually will build everything, including, for example, the AeroSwift binary. But yeah, I mean, if you want to keep it simple, like I want in here, just download that and that will actually do the job. Once you have finished, you know that you can just in command line, you can execute the binary AeroSwift like that. So you have like a nice shell. First, before we start, we need also to make sure that Docker is running. I mean, Docker desktop is running on Windows. You need also USB. It's a USB IPD to be installed. So that means a binary like that, a USB IPD should be installed also inside your computer and also accessible in the path variable environment. Once it is done, you need then to download the latest telecom image that we have created. You can also build that yourself, but I mean, yeah, this is something that we have already prepared for you. So you can just like go to image, then you can go to remote just like to see if you have a new image. For example, in telecom, this image will do up. So we can now just put it like that. Up. In my side, it is already pulled. I wanted to just like keep things simple. Once it is done, for example, here, we can run the container like that. I mean, we'll be able to run the container that way. Sorry, that way. So you can run. Then you can precise the image, printers, RF Swift, and then telecom. And then you can name it like telecom something. All right, I support telecom too. There's like no image for that. Wait a second. Yeah, because telecom does not exist, right? And here we are. So that's perfect. We can we can actually do many things in there. But first, before we start, we need also to bind the USB for the bladeRF. So if I'm connecting the bladeRF in USB, and this is where I want to show you that. Here, for example, we can have like the list of devices that are actually in there. But with the command line, Win USB list in there, you can just like show what is actually connected in there. We can see that, for example, bladeRF is not shared for the moment. But yeah, you need also, before you start, you need also to use AeroSwift as an administrator in there. Just for this case, not for the Docker. I mean, not to run the Docker or anything like that. Just to attach the USB into the to the Docker. So, if you want to attach the USB device, for the bladeRF in there, you can just do two and like that. Sorry, I forgot to put I as an argument, and also I was mistaken in there. So it's 210. Perfect. Now it should be good. So in this side, we should be able to detect it. So I will just like, if I can, yeah, the bladeRF bladeRF CLI up like that, we can see the new on bladeRF working in there. That's perfect. So then what we need, what we need to do is to start yet, actually. But before we start yet, we need also to configure it, right? So for the configuration, we should go, for example, in user local etc. I mean, yet also like that as well. And then we should also configure here subscriber and the YateBTS comp like that. I mean, for example, for my case, it is already configured. So yeah, I configured that, but I also configured, for example, the band here. So here, I have put the band like that. I have also put the RFCN for that. So I use the band 1800 and the RFCN 512. So that's perfect. You should also make sure that subscriber is also configured in your case. So like that up, you can accept everyone from front, for example, and you configure it like as usual, for example, in yet. When it is configured, I mean, you will see. I mean, this is kind of crazy because you just need, I will just like run yet, for example, here. Just also be sure that you have flashed the bladeRF with the right firmware. I mean, if you're not sure about the firmware is always also provided in there. So for example, if you go to telecom normally, you will see, for example, in 2G, you will see, for example, the firmware that is actually provided for that here. For my case, it is this one. For other case, for example, if you have like the XA4, it will be this one, etc. So yeah, let's run YateBTS, for example, here and see what is happening. So now I will just show you that working. So let's see now if we can see any network in there. Normally we should see like a network which has a very low gain also as well in here. So we can see like many networks that are legitimate network in here. Yeah, now we can see software radio system in there. Perfect. That's ours. Can we connect to it? Perfect, we can connect to it, right? And so as you can see, we are connected. And then, we can do like some interception if we want. So then we should actually use also IP tables rules in order to for and also the IP forward in order to forward all the traffic in order to get also the GPRS. So for that, it's also possible to for that also in Windows. Wait a second, I can show you that. But also, all the internet requests in GPRS will be very slow, but yeah, I mean, it's possible to do that. So if you want to route all the traffic, you can install IP table and also IP route 2 in the Docker container. So like that, you can then use the following command. For example, I would just like change the session in screen. Wait a second, up like that. And you can forward the IP traffic, use also the IP masquerade in order to do forward all the traffic on the interface that is precised by YateBTS. And also what I did just in case, and to force also the traffic to go from one interface to another, I just forced the forward of the traffic between the GSA tune to ATH0 and also the inverse. So like that, I'm sure that the traffic will be well forward without any issue. And if we just like use, for example, NC localhost like that, and the port like that, we'll be able also to see the context, the GMM context in which has been created. So HGSN list like that. And we can see, for example, the MSI, which has also this IP, which is cool because now if we want, for example, to see what is happening in there, we can go here. Wait a second. I can just like maybe go to the best a website in the world. So it will be very, very slow, but you can see that here the G for GPRS is on. And so you can actually go to internet, but it will be very slow. So yeah, basically it will be better to do like the interception in 4G or 5G. But yeah, as you can see, we can do that in with bladeRF and YateBTS, which is painful to actually compile in Windows, for example. I will probably show you also other demos working also with SSRun, etc., and also other software inside AeroSuite images. But yeah, I mean, this is that for this video. I hope you liked it. And if you have any question, please ask also on the comments. If you also like that, I mean, comment it also, thumb bump. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. See you next time.